If you can leverage thousands and thousands of patients and you can have the machine determine algorithms by which to use that information, test that information, and come up with predictions, that's certainly better at predicting how patients are going to do than we are by looking at an x-ray preoperatively and some simple measures of range of motion.
It's a very smart way of being able to look into the future by using hard data to help you navigate difficult corners. Just by looking at small changes in your individual patient information, you can see with predictive analytics how the results will change just by making small changes to different variables. Now with these predictive models, we're able to actually see how our patients are going to do, effectively seeing into the future.
So the Predict Plus software is very simple to use. It's easy to log on. It's very easy to enter the information. There's not that many discrete fields that need to be entered, and most of the fields that need to be entered are things that we routinely capture in the office when we do an intake examination. So there's very little you have to do for the core Predict Plus. There's some more questions, but not a lot, that you'd have to do if you wanted to add ASES and constant score predictions. But the basic data set is very basic, and so it's relatively easy in the normal workflow of the office. Predict Plus makes you step back a layer and actually think through it and think through the ramifications of what you decide to do to a patient. So there are definitely cases where I thought an anatomic was going to be the right way to go based on patient's age, wear pattern, but clearly Predict Plus said reverse would be better. And I'm willing to take that leap of faith because I understand and I've spent some time trying to understand the algorithms and how it is that machine learning and Predict Plus in particular is able to make the predictions that it does. We should be harnessing information and making decisions based on the best evidence and not just what's worked for us in the past. And so I think it's equally challenging and equally important for experienced surgeons to use the data to make decisions as opposed to just resting on what they've done before that's worked. And so as a new physician where you have little experience, potentially you're not surrounded by other more experienced surgeons, giving you the power to understand what you're likely to experience or have your patients experience based on your decisions preoperatively, I think is very, very powerful.
So one of the specific circumstances that I can recall in the office with Predict Plus was I had a patient that came in that didn't have a whole lot of pain but had some functional impairment and came in specifically to get a reverse shoulder replacement because of the results that a neighbor or a friend had and was very convinced that this is the operation that he wanted. So we sat down and went through Predict Plus, and I was able to show this patient that yes, his pain relief was going to be very similar, but based on the model, he was going to lose a few degrees of rotation. He didn't like that at all. So I told him, I said, in this situation, you should probably wait until you have symptoms that really warrant this operation and stop being so enthusiastic about having an operation that you may not need yet. And he agreed and decided not to have the operation done. So it was helpful in my situation to talk a patient out of having an operation that I didn't think that they really needed. We had the capacity to really look not just down the street, but down the street, around the corner, and down the street beyond that. So, you know, you can use machine learning to do lots of different things, and this really has opened the door for us to do some magical stuff in shoulder arthroplasty.
I believe in the product, and I think it's powerful, and I think it's far more powerful than the experience any one individual surgeon, including myself, has based on past experience.